All right, this weekend in Al's garage, we're going to be putting on this molding, stainless steel molding here, and it goes right into these little holes. First thing you need to do is just kind of size it up so you know which side is left and which side is right. They have a bend to them that kind of matches the car, but also on the back one is a bit of a bevel. As you can see, a bit of a bevel right here that kind of matches up, and it'll match up with the slant of the rear light right there. The way these things go on is just with rivets, but there's a consideration with these rivets. The rivets, let me see if I can see here, they have a little washer, and this is what will clip onto, this will clip onto the, here we go. This will clip onto the actual groove, right? But aside from these, there's also a, each section has a screw in as well that kind of goes in, and when you screw that in, it'll go into the one end. In this case, in the front, it goes into the big hole, and on the doors, it goes in the big hole that's in the middle. So you have to take the inside door panel off in order to gain access to that. And there's another one at the end. The one in the back here is getting access to that from the trunk. The only other consideration here is when you're putting these rivets in, these are a water intrusion issue, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use a clear silicone sealer. And I'm gonna put a little ring of silicone around each of these as it goes in so that it will seal off this hole and prevent any water from passing through or into the door or into the side panels. And so that should take care of that. Quick little process today. Celebrating the holidays, so hope you don't mind a little bit of Christmas music in the background. Here you can see I got a little bit of silicone in there. I'm gonna drive this in on the flat side with my rivet gun here. We'll go ahead and get started.
Make sure you put the flat side for your car and not the other way around, right? This little bell right here is the molding's gonna catch on. Thank you.
I don't know if you can see, there is a very, very subtle bevel. Very subtle bevel right here. This is not a 90 degree angle. And that meets up with the door from the front fender. So aside from matching the curve, you need to also match up that little bevel. It's very subtle. You see, it's just not quite 90 degrees. So when you're getting ready to put this end piece on, if you're on the door, you'll be putting it in the middle, but on the front fender, it's on the very front, right up here. So you just need to kind of get that ready to go into there. You might be able to put some silicone on this side, but I'm gonna see if I can get it on both sides. Got a little bit of silicone on there. Thank you. Another one of those where it has a very slight, has a very slight little angle on it. When you line it up with the back of the door, there's just a little bit of a slope. So, you know, just check before you push them in and make sure it's all connected. Just check to make sure. Again, this one goes in the middle because it's got to match up with this hole right here. You can see that. The little nut that goes on this is a 3/8. I got my little 3/8 here. So you can get it ready. If you can get a driver in there, there's a 3/8 inch driver will work, but there's not a lot of room to play inside the door. No kind of intrusion, everything's nice and square. Alright, on the back side.
But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. Sure, it's Christmas once a more. In a hurry, shopping to the
Alright, so I want to point out one little thing here. So this last piece here, it has a screw, but even when you tighten that screw all the way down, this little gap, oops, let's see if I can get a good focus. This little gap right here, it needs to be taken up. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to put a screwdriver or a flat surface in here. I'm just going to bend this so that this is a bit concave. That way when I pull this screw tight, it'll push it back out and it will be taut. All right, so let me explain real quick what I did here. So when you get to the end here, you want this to be just a little bit tighter so that when it draws close, it'll come snug. So what I did was I put a screwdriver right in there, just did a lot of little tiny taps with a hammer. I don't want to create a crease or anything. I don't want to make it bend. All I want to do is just coax it so that it's just a little bit more of a curve right here. And you'll see what it does. All right, so when you pull it tight now, can you see how that comes right down to nothing? It's just a suggestion. I know these things are factory fit, but you want to put the spring in it so that when you tighten it, it's going to stay tight. You don't want to get snags on there. All right. Let's go ahead and throw this nut on there. That's nice and snug. See how that tapers down real nice? You can see it comes just a little tighter right here. That's good. So there you go. Side molding installed. Not that difficult. Make sure that you put some silicone sealer in there so that you get a good water seal. It's not that difficult if you plan ahead and just do it methodically. This will probably be our last project video for this season. I'll probably do one more project recap that'll cover everything that I did during the year this year. If you have any questions or anything that you'd like me to cover in that next video, please make a comment. I'll be glad to go over anything that I worked on. If you had questions on, we'll go over it on the video on the year in review. Next year, we're going to be working on getting this engine running. We still have to do the distributor, the ignition, and rebuild our DCOE 45 Weber carburetor. And that'll be it, and then we'll get that thing running. The one of the next things we're also going to do is we're going to go over instrumentation. I'm going to take this dash out. We're going to get all the instruments tested and reinstall this dash wiring harness. And I'll walk everybody through that. So that'll be another upcoming video. All right, cheers. Have a happy Christmas.